Good morning, friends. Today's topic is flip the classroom activity. We are going to develop the flip the classroom activity with the help of this presentation. Before that, I plan to give some introduction about the flip the classroom and the traditional classroom and what are all the activities involved in flip the classroom. What is flipped classroom? Is an instructional strategy and a type of blended learning that reverses the traditional learning environment by delivering instructional content often online outside of the classroom. It moves activities including those that may have traditionally been considered homework into the classroom. Okay, we are going to conduct classes and we are going to record those classes as a videos, and we are going to plan, ask the students to work in home, to watch the videos in home and ask them to come before the class. Afterwards, we are going to give some homeworks. What are the things which we are giving in workout in home? We are going to practice the homeworks in our class and we make the students more engaging in our classroom. What is the difference between the flipped classroom and traditional classroom? In the traditional model of classroom instruction, the teacher is typically the central focus of a lesson and the primary discriminator of information during the class period. The teacher responds to questions while students refer directly to the teacher for guidance and feedback. So, what is the flipped classroom? Intentionally shift instruction to the learner-centered model. It is learner-centric teaching, in which the class time explores topic in greater depth and creates meaningful learning opportunities while educational technologies such as online videos are used to deliver content outside the classroom. In a flipped classroom, content delivery may take a variety of forms. Often video lessons prepared by the teachers or third parties. We can share some YouTube links also. Ask the students to watch those videos and come with the solution for a particular assignment. We can clip some work assignment in home and if they answer the question, they get the clear content knowledge. Afterwards, when they enter into the class, we are going to give some further inputs and we ask them to solve some problems. Although online collaborative discussions, digital research and text readings may be also used. In flipped classroom, also we redefine in-class activities. In-class lessons accompanying flipped classroom may include activity learning, active learning, that is more traditional homework problems among other practices to engage students in the content. Class activities vary but may include using mathematical manipulation, emerging mathematical technologies, the future technologies. If we give the max homework, then we can also begin sell some future directions, in-depth laboratory experiments, original document analysis, debate or speech presentations also, and even discussion on the particular topic or peer review, and also project-based learning and skill development or concept process. We can use any one in-class activity for a particular class. Now I am going to give the flipped classroom activity visual presentation. So first I am going to give the introduction about myself and what the topic I am going to plan for flipped classroom activity. I am planning basic SQL in database management system. So and after that, this box contains basic SQL. Database management system is my domain name. Computer science engineering is my branch name. And the target audience are third year UG students in CSE department and the organization, that is Kalasalingam University. So first for out class activity, afterwards in class activity. There is two segments, out class activity and in class activity. In out class activity, what are the learning objective and key concepts and what are all the assignments we are going to give. In in class activity, what are the things we are going to plan and also learning objective, separate learning objective. My learning objective of out class activity: at the end of watching the video, what the student should be able to get, okay? Understand the database concept, to design relational data model using SQL. What's the level of understanding? Okay, just they understand. Afterwards, explain basic SQL query creation using insert delete command. This is based on apply level, okay? And formulate using SQL solutions to a broad range of query and data update problems. This is on apply level, both understand level and apply level. So what are the key terms, key concepts to be covered? Yeah, that is the basic SQL, data definition language and data manipulation language. Afterwards, this is my outclass activity design. So what is the video source? That is very important to check whether the video is shared under Creative Commons license. So we are going to share the YouTube video and what is the license of the particular video. Afterwards, I am going to divide the videos, the particular video, single video into three different segments. So first part, creating a video from a video 3 minutes video, 3.10 minutes video, which demonstrate create database in SQL. In video 2, that is 2.48 minutes, inserting values into tables using SQL. And video 3, that is 6 minutes to 7.34 minutes, that is deleting and updating table in the SQL. So we are going to give the topics which are covered in the particular segment, video segment, what is the duration of the particular contents. Okay, these are all the things we are going to describe clearly in this particular table. Okay. Then only students can able to identify the particular topic under this particular segment, and also they can able to answer the questions which we are going to ask in our assessment strategies. Okay, now first we described our learning objective, and afterwards of the video and the Creative Commons license, afterwards the segments of videos. Now we are going to give the how we are going to aligning the assignments with each learning objective. So first learning objective, we are taking my first learning objective. I am going to ask the question from the particular topic, okay, particular 3 minutes. In the 3 minutes video, I am going to ask the question, assessment strategy, create a university database with the particular ID, name, department name, salary, and course table with course ID, course name, credit, section table with course ID, class building, and student table with name, department name, and total credits. Okay, by watching, and I am giving the additional instruction like what is the expected duration. The students need to watch 3 minutes video, the particular video 3 minute segment, and he need to answer. Okay. So what is the additional instruction? Watch a video V1, that is my video segment 1, and then answer question Q1. Right? Next question. Next learning objective is my explain basic SQL query creation using insert, delete, and update commands. Okay. So I am giving two questions I am going to ask based on the insert query and delete query. I ask the student table, the particular table, ask the students to credit attribute is greater than 100. In a particular department, salary is greater than $10,000. Okay, so I am going to ask the students to insert the table, contents in the table, and also delete the course table. Okay, these are all the two activities, assessment activities planned for the particular learning objective. And the expected duration to watch is 4 minutes. And what is the additional instruction given? Watch video V2 and then answer for the question Q1 and Q2. That meets the learning objective. Next one, learning objective 3, how we are assigning the assessment. Okay, that is formulate using SQL solution to broad range of queries and data update problem. So what I am doing, I am going to update query. We are going to teach update query. So the question is from update query, and after expected duration of watching is 3 minutes. I asked to watch the video V3 and answer the question. Okay, and also asked to submit the students all the question answer before 3 hours before coming to the class. Okay, total activity duration is 10 minutes. Okay, so what is the duration of video and activity? Okay, he is going to spend total 15 to 20 minutes to watch the video and also as well as to answer the questions. Okay, then class activity, when he returned back to the class, what we are going to do, what is the learning objective? Solve real life scenario problems by creating database, that is the analyze level, and second one, implement database creation and modification using SQL, this is also an analyze level. What are the key concepts? We are going to apply the database creation in real world problem and implementation using SQL. Okay, what are the activities planned in class activities? First one is we are going to plan think, pair, share, and another one is concept clarification using peer instruction. So what we are going to do here, we are going to pose 2 questions and also to start up the class provide summary of the basics of database and implementation of SQL. First we are going to give the introduction, and we are going to implement the concepts. Then we are asking the query questions like which SQL command is used to create a table in a database. Okay, create table, the option 2 is the right answer. So we are going to ask the question and make them to answer for the particular question. Afterwards, we are going to ask how we are going to insert volatile as the last name in a person table. Okay, so what we insert into table name, how we are going to insert. Okay, So insert into person, last name, values, words, and so that will be the option one is the right answer. And we are going to use the how we are going to change. Okay, this is my learning objective 3. Okay, Nilsson Hansen into Nilsson in last name. So what will be the query? The update query. We are going to use the update query. Okay, update persons. Okay, set table last name. We are going to update the last name. And afterwards, last question with SQL, how we are going to delete the record with where the first name is Peter. So we are going to check the condition first name where first name is equal to Peter, delete from person. So the second option is right. So we are going to discuss these answers in the class and make them more engaging. Okay, active learning. We make the students active with the by this activity. And afterwards, we are going to peer instruction strategy. We are going for a question, for a given question that identify the syntax. Okay, we ask the identify the syntax and ask them to write the syntax and discuss with the nearby student. Okay, near peers. So afterwards, we are going to listen to the explanation of the teacher. So in the think pair share activity, what instructor does is first you are going to give the premises, real world problem, car insurance company, person, cow, accident, owns, participated, these are on the table names and column names present. We are going to ask two questions and ask them to think. Okay, recall all the database concept, that is data manipulation language, data definition language, and ask them to recall the syntax for insert, delete, update command for 5 minutes. Afterwards, pair. We are going to pair the answer with the nearby student. Okay, compare your answers. Okay, with the nearby students for 5 minutes. Okay, if the students are not sharing with the neighbors, the instructor going to move around the class and make them more engaging. And afterwards, we ask the instructor ask the students to share the answers and going to make the discussion more interactive by asking all the students question, and they are going to share the answers, correct answers with the clear syntax, and we are going to define the example. So after the class, they will be very clear and understanding data definition language, data manipulation language. So we are going to create a query with the create command, insert command, delete, update command with the more than 2 or 3 examples and 1 quiz and 1 assessment. So the concept become very clear, and also the teaching is very effective. We are planning for out class activity, in class activity. The flip the classroom is a very, very effective learning methodology. So apply on your subjects and you get a good outcome. All the best. Thank you for listening. And we are justifying the, sorry I ran good, the justifying the active learning strategies, critical thinking, higher order thinking. We meet all the objective, that is active learning, what I have discussed. Okay, we have critical thinking based on induced in the class while solving the real world problem, and enable their higher order thinking and peer discussion, summary of topic, feedback, all this very helpful to make the active learning. Okay, that's all. Thank you.